Well, hey guys, the drop list for Supreme Drop today, so I'm just going to walk through and kind of show you guys what I like, what is released in this whole season. So it's Spring Summer 2019. Sorry if my voice is a bit iffy, I just did a post concert last night. I can't really, my voice still hasn't really recovered. But yeah, let's jump into it. So I'm start by going down the whole items and just showing you the ones I like, and I'll show you them more in detail. Because I feel like there's a lot to go over, and it's going to be such a long video if we go over every single item.
Wait a minute, what was that? No way. The drop list. Oh, boys, let's go.
So firstly, we just have the first couple of jackets. So we have the spider web. Hello?
Yo, did you see the drop list just dropped? The spellings, there's so many hyped items, oh my god.
Yeah, well, I was just about to do a video on it, actually, yeah. Like, that's what I'm doing right now, you've kind of just interrupted, yeah.
Just cannot wait for that Bogo.
You're actually such a hype beast. It's not just Bogo's drop, there's not even Bogo released, it's just 25th anniversary.
No, I'm not a hype beast, what are you on about? It's just to make my Insta pop. Come on, I don't have any followers, like... on a Jack underscore Nisbet, like, you need to just, like, no one follows Jack underscore Nisbet, like, it just, like, some items popping on there.
Right, okay, well, yeah, right, you have one there, right, bye. Such a hype beast, honestly. Sorry about that, guys. So we gotta jump straight off the jackets. So the spiderweb quilted work jacket is one of the first items you see here. So it is, although I do like the design on it, it's just quite a thick jacket. It's got the Supreme branding on the top left area, but it just pretty much says Supreme. It's got a spiderweb design on it. Pretty sick item. It comes in three colourways, as you can see, the orange, black and teal cyan colour. Next we have almost a leather varsity jacket, yeah. It's a lot of distressing on it, you can see with it up the top. There's a lot of bleeding colours that would, it does give it an old look, and if that's what they went for, to give it pretty much a aesthetic that's been really ancient, then it works. I'm just going to skip over this. I don't even want to talk about this. It's a cheetah print. Why? I do not understand the trend of it. Next is the patchwork hunting jacket. I love this. I love the multicoloured one. Although it does have the Supreme Arc logo on the back, it's still in the same piece. I can imagine it'd be hard to match stuff with, but to be honest, why not? It's a standout piece. Usually this piece could be used in an outfit that's quite well put together, and you just have this as a standout piece. The retail for this will be quite high, as it is a Harrington jacket, but if I can pick it up, I'll definitely try it. Next couple of items are quite weak in the sense. You've got the Stars jacket, which is just literally like a star on the side of the jacket, so I can quite show you. If you load it, yeah, so it's just a star on the side of the jacket, and it's got a Supreme logo on the back, which is just a classic. Next you have the panelled windbreaker, which is just two different colours on the same jacket. Panelled, yeah, the colours are nice, but it's not a piece that I'd pick up. Next, for a zip car jacket, which has got zips, it's got five zips in total, yeah. Two zip pockets on the top, two zip pockets on the bottom, and you've got a zip in the middle. It comes with a pretty much just like a, it's wool lined, it'll be comfy, just not my type. Next you have the floral track jackets. Yeah, they're not the nicest. And although a lot of people do like floral stuff, as you see last season, a lot of the floral stuff actually went first when people didn't expect it to. So never put it out, it can always do a lot better than everyone honestly thinks. Next couple of jackets just have the Supreme spell it on the hood. This one's really nice, this one was leaked. It's a bonded logo puffy jacket. It comes in red, green, almost a light blue colour, and a black. It's a water resistant jacket. It has the Supreme logo pushed into it practically. Looks nice. Got a denim jacket. Yeah, this one has the Supreme City background on it. It's nice, it comes in black and the normal denim colour. Next is one of my favourite pieces of the drop. It's the Raiders stuff. So there's a couple Raiders items in this. This is one of the nicest ones. It's the Raiders jacket. It's got the old English font Supreme with the Raiders logos. Looks insane. It looks really good. It's definitely probably one of the items I will be picking up this season. There's not a lot of them. It's actually getting downvoted quite a bit right now. I don't know why. It's 137 up votes and 325 down. I don't know why though, to be honest. It's branded heavily, but it's a nice jacket. Hopefully it means it's not going to do well and I can pick it up without any hassle. That would be good. Next, we almost have a tartan print with the Gore-Tex. It's the Gore-Tex collab jacket. I'm just going to skip over that though, because it's literally just the Supreme Gore-Tex usual branding on it. Next we have this isn't my style, but this is an insane jacket. It's a leather jacket with a Ghost Rider pattern on it. It's got the Ghost Rider on the front and then flames up the sleeves with the two red box logo spell outs and a couple branded sleeves with fans sitting in a couple other logos on it. Comes in white and black head. Definitely insane, not my style though. I'm just going to quickly scoot past some of these because they're just not that hype. There's a leather jacket on the top right, just in black. There's a vest almost here. There's white, it comes in red, black and in blue. This is a nice jacket. It's a Reaper work jacket, nice print, would definitely pick up. Next you've got the Wolf jacket that was leaked a couple weeks ago. Not my style, but you've got... But yeah, a lot of people will buy it because it has a big massive Supreme brand on it. I don't judge them. I can see it being used so well in outfits, but I could pull it off. We've got the full black suit. Yeah, and next we've got the Gore-Tex ponchos. This is just one of these items that you have to just accept, isn't it? It's a nice... There's going to be so many hype beasts on the drops and the wearing this. I can just see it. You'll have Ari Petrie out here just flexing in London, just thinking he's the biggest hype beast in the world. This item here, this Grand Prix parka is doing insane. It's doing actual numbers. This is insane. This is one of the items that I did see first, and it's so nice. But definitely a good pickup. It'll be expensive though. I'm going to jump straight to this. The Gons matte work jacket. This is insane. There's so many details to this I don't think people are seeing because it's not doing well. But there's so much detail in it. You've got Fear Street, you've got like Cannonspell Boulevard, like Good Sex Drive. Like it's such a nice piece and I don't think a lot of people are seeing the detail. And I kind of hope it stays like this because if I can pick it up without people actually realizing the actual potential behind it, yeah, I'm definitely going to try it. I'm just going to quickly jump over the shirts because there's not, I don't like any of them, but although the designs are quite nice, they're just not for me. Got the Hardware shirt, it's almost just like practically the jackets, but there's a lot of them being repeated over the shirts. So you've got the Reaper, print and it's been taken over. You've just got the Supreme spell out that was on the denim jacket previous, which has just a couple spell outs on it, that's been turned into a shirt. We've got a couple more. Like this one, this is probably the one that's going to go the most. Still not an item for me, but it's the Racing Logo Work shirt. So it's just got a couple of them, but they have the spell out on them. Lastly with the shirts, we're just going to be talking about this camo shirt. This almost reminds me of something from Bape. I don't like Bape, I'm not into it, but it's still a nice piece. It's a silk shirt, so the retail will be quite expensive. There's actually hardly any branding on it except from the pocket, which is good because although I keep saying this, you don't really need a lot of branding on it to make it a nice item. I love when people take Supreme items that aren't hype, that don't have a lot of spell outs that can be just used in any term and just do what they want with it. Honestly, it's perfect. Next we'll be talking about the tops and sweaters. There's only a couple of these that I do like. As I say, there is a ton of good items this season. It's just none of them, there's not a lot for me, so I think it's going to be a slow season, I think, for me. All down to BT. This is the football tee, part of the Wu-Tang. It sadly passed, but I'll quickly put some in for you guys. So it's to represent the 36 Chambers. Also, good timing for this because the Wu-Tang are coming with also Public Enemy and De La Soul. For at least in Glasgow, they're doing a show, and I will be wearing this if I cop this. They're coming in May, I'm going, cannot wait. Yeah. So we've got the identification for food coupons, it's just got the Easter egg here for the 36 Chambers. We've got him looking like a tall G over here. There's a lot more pieces with this on. There's a rug later on, There is also a skate deck with this printed on, and the skate deck will definitely be getting bought. The rug looks insane also, but it's just such a nice design. Definitely a shout out to him. This comes with the yellow top, the red top and the blue top. Next we have quite a hype piece actually. This is the Raiders brand thermal. I need to pick this up. I'm going to go for the cream. I'm not sure about the retail yet, but it's usually may possibly be, I'm going to say 130-ish. Probably less, maybe dearer. It's good, it's got the maroon colour, black colour, cream. All it is just an arc logo on the sleeve and with the Raiders in the just in the middle. It's just simple, but it's good, it's nice, does its job. We have the red rum baseball jersey. This was leaked a couple of weeks ago too, but yeah, it's not much to say about it. It's got the Supreme 94 on the back. This obviously relates to the established date, which is 1994 for Supreme. So it's just, it comes in the white colourway, the green and black and red, all with different decaling and at least the accents around the red, the black writing at least, so at least they've kept it a bit different. Here we see the quite a hype piece actually, a lot of people are talking about it, it's the cycling jersey. It has the Supreme logo on the front with it on the sleeves also, and then down the sides it comes in the black and green, teal and white and red and white. Gonna have all these cycling hype pieces just shredded about the place. Although it probably won't even go with them, it'll go to resellers. We have the metallic jacquard crew neck. I love this piece, it's, although there is branding on it, it's quite minimalistic in a sense. There it is, it's all cotton, it's doing quite well in upvotes actually, so this might be quite a hype piece. It's got the New York Supreme branding on it, just in different text sizes. We have the needlepoint patch long sleeve top. This is insane, I do like this. Not sure what colour yet, a properly kind of rustic camo. Does look nice. It's a cold cotton, so the price might be up for retail, but although probably something I would still call. As I said, just a couple, there's not a lot that I like, it's just quite minimal. I'm not going to go for much this season. Try to cut down a bit. I'm going to probably be more into palettes this season, to be honest. There's a lot more palettes items that I do like. Supreme's still doing a good job, and I'm hoping to see the same pieces that come with the collabs, but I'll have to wait and see with them. So on the screen we have the S logo colour block today. I do like colour block stuff, but the colourways they went with this, I think they actually look quite good. I'm just not sure what ones yet to go with. That's because I feel like the orange one is so out there, I don't know if that's for me. Next we have the Gons embroidered map hoodie. This is the same that was on the jacket, but now it's on the hoodies. I still like this blue colourway, so I'm probably going to go for it. And then lastly for the sweatshirts, we're going to finish off with the Formula crew neck. Yeah, I know you see that red box logo, but this is the colourway I like. Although the black one looks quite nice, I just want to see the difference between, like, obviously what actually happens with this box logo down here. Nice, it's just also a bit of colour blocking going on. I'll quickly breeze through the t-shirts because these were late a couple hours ago before the drop list actually came out. I don't like them this season, but this is only the ones. There's still a lot more to come out, supposedly. There is still the summer tees, etc., which will be released a lot later. So I'll just scroll down and let you guys see them. I'll just pop into every single one of them. You've got Christopher Walken King of the New York tee. You've got the kids tee. You've got the fruit tee, which has been seen everywhere. You've got the middle finger to the world. This is one of the probably pieces that I like the most on the t-shirts. It's just not, there's not a lot in it. It's just something simplistic. You've got the Not Vikings tee, the hard goods tee, so it's just the Supreme branding along the middle. You've got the Creeper tee, you've got the Real tee, you've got the Fronts tee, which is also an accessory you'll see later. You've got Lida and Swan tee, I'm just gonna have to cut loads of that. I don't want demonetized, even though I don't get monetized, but it's a bit graphic. There's an original sitting tee, so that's the tees for the season that have been leaked so far. There is still a lot more to be leaked, except to wait and see. Same with the pants, there's not a lot of pants that I do like, so we'll just quickly scroll through them, I'll let you see on the screen. Although they have got the Ghost Rider panelling again, looks nice. Definitely would probably prefer the jacket over it, but the retail for these will be so high, it's all leather. You have the maps, you have the Gons map design on the trousers also, as well as the Raiders design on the pants also, so you can have a full suit practically of Raiders, why not? Pants also have the shorts, so we have the shorts here, Not a lot of the designs. You've got the Grand Prix design here on the screen. You've got the Maps T. You've also got the S logo, side panel. You've got the Old Dirty B T. You've got the shorts here with the Old Dirty B. It's just the same as the design on the t-shirt, but it's on the shorts instead. A couple of hats this season. There's always hats. They're always the same. It's just the spell out on it. We've got a couple of S logos that we'll be trying to pick up at least one of them. It's a Gore-Tex one this time. You also have the Supreme London bandana, so this will probably be just a Supreme London accessory. So you'll probably just be able to get it if you're at the drop in the London store, which I will be able to do, so I'm not getting one practically is what I'm saying. So we're going to jump into probably the most hype. Everybody loves accessories, and these are accessories right now, this is most of them. So you have the front keychains, it's probably like a grill, 24 karat plated keychain, so that'll be expensive. You've got the full frame, it's got the Supreme watermark practically on it. You've just got the usual, like the socks, the boxers, the Hames collab, it's the cheetah print this season. Not feel so good about it. You've got the grinder, coffee grinder, slash kettle I think it is. 6 cup capacity. You have the NBA headband, which will be a definite sell-out piece if you're going for resale. This will be one item to resale, and depending on the retail, it could be quite high resale. You've got the Supreme snorkel set also. You've also got the pocket knife, which will probably be US exclusive because the UK haven't really don't like a lot of items being shipped here. So yeah, it probably won't be the UK. The Discovery dry bag that's waterproof, so it can be used for a lot of stuff. You've got a Supreme torch on the screen. You've got a red and a olive colour, like a light olive. You've got the Uzi pillow covers. You've got the crown keychain as well. The Supreme lure fishing. Also, the last couple items, you have the NBA wristband, the Supreme water pistol, this lighter, the Old Dirty B rug. Insane. You have the Pool Cue, take it apart and then put it away. You've got the Supreme band-aids for everyone taking the L's, you need to cover them up. You've also got the Supreme slippers, why not? You've also got the Supreme slippers that are cotton with the rubber soles, as well as the locks, the water bottles. The drum kit is the main thing this season, the big thing. It's actually, it's doing well in upvotes right now. You've also got the hand towels, the measuring tapes, the director's chair, and lastly, in accessories, you have the Supreme Hot Wheels truck. So the last two items is the bags and the skateboard. So you have the normal utility pouches that are in the camo, black, red, blue. The colourways for this season's bags is the red, it's a light blue colour that you've seen in a lot of items. The olive colour and the black. So you have the normal backpacks. You have the shoulder pouches, it's got a camo, black and red. You've got the tote bags with the Gons map design on it. You've got the duffel bags in the same colourways, the waist bags in the same colourways, the shoulder bags in the same colourways, the tote backpacks, as well as the organiser pouches. Lastly, finishing off with the skate, you've also got the wheels that are coming. They come out every season. You've got the skateboard that I'm definitely picking up. It's older B skateboard that has just the design on it, just layered, definitely still a nice piece though. You've got the Molotov Kid Supreme Skate deck, comes in three different colours, a blue, black and a pink. You've got the Lee Dan Swan skateboard, the design that's a bit raunchy from earlier on. You've got the trucks that come out every season. You've got the Supreme Spell Out airbrushed floral design, it comes in black and white with a wood finish on the top. Second last item, we've got the Sheer Skate deck. And lastly, you've got the Fruit skateboard. It's actually quite hyped. That was the Supreme drop list of 2019 spring summer. There's still a lot of collabs to be released. Not a lot. You won't find out them until the drop list probably drops for that week. Especially, I'll be doing drop list probably videos every week. And if I'm popping anything that week, I will be doing a live cop. If not, I'll be talking about my favourite items for that week. So if you guys want to stay tuned, there will also be Palace videos coming up hopefully. I might do a review on the Palace lookbook that came out a couple days ago. I started one the other day, but I didn't like how it was finishing, so I stopped. But if you guys want to see more, leave a like, subscribe, any comments, definitely help me out. Just tell me how to improve, what you liked about the video, what you disliked. If you did dislike the video, leave a dislike and tell me why. Thank you guys. See you soon. Peace.